like in Wellhaven, you know.
Wellhaven?
Quietly swims a wild duck. Johann Sebastian Wellhaven's poem about a duck. The beautiful creature, or whatever he calls it, that is fatally wounded, swims to the bottom of the sea, clamps hold of the seaweed, and dies alone.
Well, Tordis Braham didn't die alone. She took someone down with her.
Nevertheless.
Were you a little smitten by Fru Braham as well, perhaps, Brodal?
Smitten? Well, she was a beautiful woman. No one who met her remained unaffected. That's how she was.
His face wore a transported expression, as though it wasn't 5 minutes since she was last here. I went into the fitting room to take off the suit. Where had I been in 1957? Could I have crossed her path by chance in the town centre, where the threads of lives and destinies were interwoven over decades and centuries? When I came out, I said, "Of course you remember her two daughters from then." He eyed me from a distance, still lost in his dreams.
"Yes, yes. Berit's even become a lawyer."
"She's defending your nephew."
"Yes."
"You haven't been following the case?" Again, his eyes narrowed in a way peculiar to him.
"No, why would I? It's not exactly a topic of conversation in the family. This is basically my sister's problem, and Telia's, of course."
"You mean..." His frustration boiled over.
"For Christ's sake, it must be possible to have a woman without forcing yourself on her."
I nodded. "I agree with you. But Berit's clearly driven a hard line with the prosecution. By the way, they passed sentence at 3 today.